We're at Rarekind Records in Brighton. It's like the best shop in the area. Every time you pop in, you're going to find something. A lot of my collection has come from here, or at least like some of the more memorable bits. What I do when I go in to any shop really is look at the wall and see where the more rarer bits are. You've got Blair Nightlife, which is a classic. This is the UK pressing on Miracle. It's like a really good slow tune. I think this is the record that I opened up with when I played at Patterns 2018 New Year's Eve. And it's just like a really good long tune, 7 minutes 20. So this is one that is just like classic, and it just really builds and builds. So that's a great record. This is Mona Ray Do Me. It's like a really good like warm-up tune because it's like mid-tempo boogie. And this is the original pressing on Park Place. It got remixed by T Scott. It's like one of the best remixes. That came out on Quality Records. But the original on Park Place is a bit rougher, one I don't have, so I'll definitely grab this. So looking at the funk section, I love to go off the labels as well, but you can't really do it like this. So what I like to do is look for records that I'm not familiar with and that look interesting and that I think will be quite good. Dame Funk, Snoop Dogg. Actually, that one was with Steve Arrington. I remember I used to really be into Dame Funk. He really inspired me because Deviation with Benji B, he was playing all of this boogie stuff that you just don't hear any DJ spin. And the way he was like introducing the tracks and talking about where the artist came from, like midway through the song, and just like with so much passion, it's just like inspired me and like I think a whole generation of people to like really discover boogie music. So I couldn't really see much in the funk. Let's go for the soul. Usually I find more in the disco section here. Luther Vandross. I used to go to record fairs a lot. I'd go to a Utrecht record fair. You can easily spend too much time in one stall and then you'll miss out because you've got other competition digging. So you have to learn to be quick. I was obsessed with collecting music, but digitally initially. More like hip hop, G-funk, 90s and 80s. And then I bought a DJ Quick record on eBay because I guess I didn't know that you could just pop into a record shop and buy records at the time. I bought one of those records because I realised that some tunes are only available on vinyl, so that's why I got that DJ Quick record. And then just bought a bit of funk things as well, and then, I don't know, just like, you just get a taste for it and then you just want more and more. I think this will be on RCA Records, just based on, or it says RCA Disco Direction. I don't know the artist, Eclipse. I think they released something which was quite rare. Jamming City, like I'm totally unfamiliar with this, so I'll pull it out just to give it a listen. I think I'm after this one. If this is the one I'm thinking of, it might be the remix by Larry Levan, Aura When I Come Home, like Wicked Bassline. I think this is the one, but I need to give it a listen. See, this is a great, see like you can get such good tunes, like this is only £5, Doing the Dog, Cream the Coco. It's got like a, I think it's definitely inspired by Chic, maybe Good Times. I can't remember the Chic tune, but for £5, like still in the shrink, you know, that's what I mean. You can get really good value for money, disco and boogie, especially from somewhere like Rarekind. Part of the joy of digging is discovering music. So anything on RCA that I don't know, I'll just give it a listen because some of the major labels are RCA, Arista, there's so much good music on there. You just know you're gonna find something quality. And usually what I like to do for funk, soul and disco is look for early 80s because that's my main style. But 79 usually has a lot of good disco as well. What's this? 1978. If, like this looks like an independent label, NAME, not one I've seen before, so worth checking out. So I've gone through the disco, the boogie, or the soul and the funk. I'm definitely happy to share the music because you can find it anyway. There's no reason to gatekeep. Maybe 20 years ago, 30 years ago, it was important because people booked you based on the music you had, but you can hear all that music on YouTube. If you're preventing people from discovering the tunes, then that's kind of a disservice to the original artist. So I feel like it's important to share. And yeah, that's what music's about, right? Sharing. This is all the hip hop and the R&B music. What I'd like to look for is electro, which is kind of hard to find. As you can see, it's not a big section, even in this hip hop shop. The original electro is like early 80s hip hop, like less rapping and more just like, I don't know, really raw beats, drum machines, synthesizers, stuff like Rich Kasson. Like he, for me, he's like the best electro producer. This is produced by Rich Kasson, or co-produced by him, and also co-produced by Jimmy Jam and Terry Lewis. Classic record, Captain Rap, Bad Times. Part two is the jam. That's the one without the rap, because the rap's kind of corny on it. It's got just the vocals, but this one, I need to find my copy, because I was thinking to play it out at a gig in a couple weeks. This is probably like mid 80s. The stuff that I really like from electro is more the early 80s, like up until 83, maybe. So this one is Grandmaster Caz, so this is probably like more hip hop. 3 pounds or 5 for 10. I've found loads of gems through here. There's so many great records that you can get for cheap. So just having a look at the titles. See, like this already, like this one. Aretha Franklin, Respect, Say a Little Prayer. It's probably got a few marks, but... oh, that's a bit marked up. It might play though, it's worth checking out. But like to have those classic tunes like this is good for like, I don't know, that just like the regular open format DJ. Say a Little Prayer is a good one to close off with. Shalimar, take that to the bank. See, like, so these are a lot of like essential classic tunes that I think these are the best way to build the collection. Like you don't really need to go for the more rare records. I know a lot of young diggers prefer to like go for the more expensive rare bits, but I feel like you need the foundation tunes to begin with. This is a classic by Gary's Gang. This is the one that they used for, is it Danny Crivet did like an edit of this? I can't remember what they called it. Maybe just Danny Crivet edit. And he kind of takes the best parts of this tune, and it's the one they use for Soul Searchers, Can't Get Enough. That like piano riff is just so classic. So this is the original. It can get quite cheesy, but it's one that I never bought because it was so cheesy. So I don't know, maybe I should copy it. Maybe do my own edit with it. I've got a record by The Night People featuring Sammy Relford. His vocals are amazing. This one looks like it's without them, but the label, The Sound of Brooklyn, STSOB, has some really good tunes, so this could be good. We got together, people. Check it out. I said a 3, 5, 4, 5, 4, 4, 4. Need some money, gotta get me some. Things gotta get better. Say to what you gonna do. Yeah, I like that. That's the B-side. This never happened before. Yeah, it's more like modern soul, that one. So I like it for the B-side. So that was £8. Not bad for something where you probably won't find this in the UK a lot. Like I'd never seen this record before. This one, a label that is a bit hit and miss, Millennium. This one's called Snatch, Another Brick in the Wall, which sounds like it should be funky. Sure about the vocals, it sounds like blue-eyed disco, but it's pretty decent. That's a maybe. think I might go for that. I like the beat. I'll spend more time on something that I think has potential. Sometimes it can be an instant, like in 5 seconds, I'm like, yep, 100% need that. So this is the Larry Levan remix, which I heard someone play at Jazz Cafe and it just sounded wicked. So it just got me dancing like mad. So it's kind of like a chill one, but I don't know, something about it, it's got a good groove. I think there might have been an instrumental on the B-side of the US pressing, if I'm not mistaken. I usually go for US pressings like 90% of the time. They just sound a bit better to me. I like the feel of the thick card sleeves and the way the labels look. So this one is French. Sounds pretty good, right? It's punchy. And you got the instrumental on the B-side. Sick. Only £5. So that's what I mean. I didn't recognize that. It doesn't look that good, but because I don't know it, got to give it a listen, and that's how I discover a lot of music. This one I don't know, on RCA, 1978. Ballad. You can just tell from the title sometimes, Pain in My Heart. So this one, Park Palace, I mentioned earlier, it's the original version before T. Scott mixed it, and one I don't have, so I'm most likely gonna grab it. But yeah, this is the vocal version. I love the intro. It's a good like track, it's a good set starter. Definitely not as good as the other version on quality, but as like a collector, I just need this. And then I'm gonna play this, which I mentioned went down really well when I played it a couple weeks back. Feel the real adrenaline. quite a long intro. Some of these records you just don't think would go down well in a club like Coco, but it just did, you know. It doesn't have to be an edit all the time or like with a banging kick drum. That one is quite rare as well, so it'll be a nice one to add to the collection again. I don't think I'd ever stop buying records. It's like a daily thing for me, pretty much, you know, like it takes up a lot of my time. It's just like not knowing what you're gonna find. You go into a shop, you end up leaving with some gems, and then you remember where you picked those up from when you're handling it at home. I like that.